Hello guys and welcome back to the channel. Looking for a new RPG mobile game to play this 2022? There are currently a lot of new great mobile games coming at the end of 2022. But not all of them are worth the wait. So, in this video I will showcase my personal favorite. Here you go. The list of top 5 upcoming awesome mobile RPGs at the end of year 2022. 5. Sword Art Online Variant Showdown. As a Sword Art Online fan myself, this title is very exciting, at least for me. The game follows an original storyline where players will experience a VR action game called Cross Edge. The game also introduces an original character called Layla. Sumire Uesaka will voice the game's original character, Layla, while Ayara Oi will perform the theme song, Answer. About the battle system. We can choose 3 characters for the battle. Each character has his or her own special techniques and skills. So be sure to form parties that exploit your opponent's weaknesses. We can use character-specific sword skills and switch between offense and defense to take down the enemies. And yes, there is a parry system. Counter enemies' special attacks with parries. Awaken the characters to unleash their true power on the battlefield. Let's just hope that the gacha rate is not too low. And it is also as F2P friendly as Sword Art Online Memory Defrag back then. The exact release date is not confirmed yet. But, we can expect to have this game released in global this 2022. Check the description for the global pre-registration link. 4. Final Fantasy VII Ever Crisis. I myself have been a Final Fantasy fan since I was still in junior high school back then. Final Fantasy VII is indeed one of the best Final Fantasy series back then. This Final Fantasy VII Ever Crisis game features chibi graphics in the overworld and stunning Final Fantasy VII Remake visuals in combat. Ever Crisis follows the battle system of the original Final Fantasy VII. Being based on the active time battle system. And using materia, weapons, summons. And limit breaks based on the original game. Yes, I know right, we probably already got too many Final Fantasy VII series all this time. Such as Before Crisis Final Fantasy VII, Dirge of Cerberus Final Fantasy VII, Crisis Core Final Fantasy VII, Final Fantasy VII Remake, Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, Final Fantasy VII The First Soldier. But for Final Fantasy fans, this game still has charm. This game is going to get released on Android and iOS. There are no planned releases for any other consoles or PC in the foreseeable future. When is the exact release date? Unfortunately, there is no confirmation of the exact Final Fantasy VII Ever Crisis release date yet, but it is expected to be released in 2022. 3. Nikke Goddess of Victory. I am personally interested in this game because of its new vibe of gameplay. Goddess of Victory Nikke is a mobile third-person shooting game. Published by SHIFTUP, the same publisher of the game Destiny Child. You can play it entirely with one hand. You aim by moving your finger on the screen. While letting go causes your character to hide behind cover. And thanks God, this game has an auto battle function. Letting you focus on the other, important, parts of the game. Auto battle unlocks the ability to play this game while doing other stuff in real life. So yes, it's a great plus for me. This game gives us a totally different point of view of watching the characters doing battle, compared to the other recently released waifu gacha games. Which is, you know what I mean. And sure thing, this game has a lot of cute waifus to collect. With an SSR rate of 4%, Nikke is definitely on the more generous side of gacha games. Let's just hope that the premium currency will be generously distributed to the players through weekly events, other than from just clearing story quests. The game is expected to be released on November 1, 2022. Check the description for the global pre-registration link. 2. Aether Gazer. Shanghai-based publisher Yostar Games, the same publisher of the game Azure Lane, has officially announced that it will be publishing the Aether Gazer. An anime-themed, action RPG, set in a sci-fi world. The graphics and character design are simply awesome. It is a fast-paced action RPG with a smooth and fluid combat system. And yes, this game is kind of similar to Punishing Grey Raven in terms of gameplay. At this moment, the game had already been released in the China region. When I made this video, I'd played the Chinese version for around 2 weeks already. I can tell that the battle gameplay is amazing. The battle gameplay consists of 3 character team gameplay. The player will control the main character, while the other two characters will be in auto battle mode. And we can manually control when to use the other two characters' ultimate skill. The skill animations are awesome, especially the ultimate skills part. This game has combo for ultimate attacks, in which you can use two characters' ultimate attacks both at once, or three characters' ultimate attacks in a single animation. There are a lot of minigames that you can play inside the Aether Gazer game, such as puzzle solving, 2D retro side-scrolling game, etc. These minigames will give you some premium currency as a reward, which is awesome for F2P players. The S-rank character gacha rate is also quite reasonable with 1.6% and up to 2.4%. Especially since this game has a 70 pulls threshold guaranteed S-rank character for the pity rate. Also, by just playing it for 2 weeks, I can already hit the S-rank character guaranteed gacha pity rate twice with the premium currency I have right now. The only downside about this game is probably only one. Where there is no auto battle function in the game. Yes, everything is manual here, lol. Aether Gazer will be supported on iOS and Android. And will be released in North America, Europe, and CE. The release date is set for Q4 2022. Check the description for the global pre-registration link. 1. Wuthering Waves. Wuthering Waves was developed by the same people who created Punishing Grey Raven, which is Kuro Games. The combat system is smooth and fluid, as you can see in the video. This game is a story-rich open-world game with a high degree of freedom, which is similar to Genshin Impact and Tower of Fantasy, with some different aspects in the game. Yes, this game has been called, another Genshin Impact killer, game. Let's just hope that this game is going to be F2P friendly, lol. This game is expected to be released globally on Android and iOS this November 2022. Check the description for more information about this game. That's all for the top 5 list. I would appreciate it very much if you guys are still watching until this point. As you can see, I tried new stuff to make this kind of top 5 list video. What do you think? Leave a comment or two to let me know. Hope you enjoyed the video. Kindly smash that like button. Also please subscribe if you haven't. Thank you for watching. See you again in the next video. Ushi Punch.
What do you guys think? This kind of new format, did you like it? Or actually kinda weird? Or should I keep continue making this kind of video for you guys? I mean, with the whole new editing stuff that I have never done before, right? And with that new voiceover! Yeah, it was not my voice, obviously. My voice is actually much cuter. Yeah, so that's all guys. Let me know what you guys think on the comment section below. Thank you for watching, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye bye. Ushi. Bye.